equality of opportunity. Let's talk about that topic in the context of the 2016 election and the major candidates. Who do you think is going to most effectively bring equal opportunity to the country between the major candidates?
Well, I think it's a little difficult to answer your question for this reason. With Trump and Hillary, you have an unknown against a known. My fear of Trump is I don't know what he's going to do. My fear of Hillary is I do. We've got a wild card against somebody who's been in public life all her life and who's basically been, I would say, on the take from day one. These are people who rent out the Lincoln bedroom. They pardon major level racketeers, drug smugglers, and crooks for money. We've had corruption in local politics, Tammany Hall, the Daily Racket in Chicago. Never before have we had a Secretary of State who figure out, she uses the phrase commercial diplomacy, and she sure has made it work commercially for her. They've got a system in which the Clintons work as a tag team, one of them collecting the down payment through a speech, and then millions and tens of millions of dollars flowing in return for favors being granted on the global scale, collecting money from foreign governments. So we have an unknown quantity against a known crook. And Hillary's talk about equality of opportunity appears to be for her. So there's no real equality of opportunity. Bernie, in my opinion, is naive, but he's at least honest. And so I think some of the appeal of Bernie is that at least here's a guy, he might have been sleeping on his neighbor's couch until last week, but nevertheless, he's not a crook. At least I'm not a crook.
So my sense is, my sense is, Cenk, you don't disagree with all of that, and you endorsed Bernie in the primary, and you've also been very critical of Hillary. So I'll pose the same question to you, but it's interesting. There is some agreement here on this topic.
Before we get to Cenk the Cenk, Dinesh hit it pretty much spot on, I have to admit. The known versus the unknown. The person on the take versus the person, who's not. A political insider who's just absolutely, just using every single ounce of her fat body and her husband's thin body to make as much money as possible. Legally, obviously, somehow, we can debate that or whatever, but it's pretty legal. The way they're doing it and getting every single penny, every nickel, every dime, every quarter, every half dollar, every single thing that they can get, collecting it while in public. And then Trump, obviously, as a private, person, real estate investor, business person, TV personality, whatever you want to call it. Everything that he's made, he's done it legally. And every dollar that he's earned has been absolutely legal. You want to debate that? That's for another day. But like I said, is at least he wasn't taking, he's not in government enriching himself through government graft. All right. But the Clintons, that's a whole new level of what they're doing. So what Dinesh basically was saying, all right, right on the mark. Let's see what Cenk the Cenk has to say.
There is some agreement, but there's also disagreement. So let me go one by one. We certainly agree that Bernie Sanders is totally honest, and that's why everybody... I stopped myself because I shouldn't say everybody, but a lot of people obviously recognize that and were behind him, and he's not part of the same corrupt system. Hillary and Donald Trump are part of the corrupt system in as counterparts. It's actually a perfect symmetry. Donald Trump brags about how he used to corrupt people, how he would give them, in essence, legalized bribes. And then the Republicans look at that and go, that's awesome. Not awesome.
But can I stop you here and challenge you? There's a complete difference between a guy who has never run for public office, who is functioning as a businessman within the crony capitalist system of New York, and somebody who's running that system. So in other words, yeah. You can't compare Trump and Hillary. Trump is essentially buying favors. Hillary's selling them. Which is worse?
I actually... So...
point, D'Souza. Takedown.
So let me take some time to address all that, to your question and your point. So I'll start with what you said, Dinesh. So first of all, I have a definitive answer on what's worse. What's worse is the people who set up the corrupt system in the first place. So oftentimes conservatives complain about, big government and they're so crony capitalists. No. The guys who fixed the system were the ones who wanted to purchase the politicians in the first place. So it's not like, oh, golly gee, you made me purchase a politician and I made 24,000% rate of return. Oops. No, they're the ones who corrupted the system in the first place. So it's not like, oh, you twist my arm. Okay, I'll give you 100 and I'll get 1,000 back.
Well, wait.
That was the whole system, Dinesh. Well, that's why they did it. They put the money in politics, not because it's an accident. It was by design. So yes, Donald Trump is worse because he is the corrupter.
Really? Really?
I just got to stop there. Cenk, you just lost it right there. You just absolutely freaking lost it, buddy. Bruh, you lost it. Trump is the corrupter because he's in private enterprise, because he's the one, okay, legalized, whatever you want to call it, giving money so that, you know, things can be done. You know how many jobs he created? You know how many businesses he made? You know how many millionaires he's produced? You know how much money and taxes and stuff he's given to the city of New York? Do you have any clue what the hell has Hillary Clinton done? Absolutely freaking nothing. Living off the graft of her husband's arse and her own big ass. That's what they're, you know, who you're selling favors or you're taking favors. Which is worse? Come on, Cenk the Jenk. I thought you were a little bit, you know, I thought you're not going to, you know, BS or whatever. That was a complete, takedown, points, reversal, everything on that one to D'Souza.
India. Yeah. To get ahead, to get a license, to get a passport, to get a ration card, you have to pay bribes. That's the system, right? Now, arguably, the fact that the government pays very little money and the citizens feel that this is the only way to get a ration card, they pay the bribe. So in that sense, they set up the system. But who do we hold accountable? The ordinary guy who can't get sugar from the store, or the guys in government who have been elected and entrusted by the people to look out for their interests? We elected Hillary, not Trump.
No.
Point D'Souza.
So, let me just say for the record, anybody who watches the Young Turks knows we're no fans of Hillary Clinton or the system. We can't stand it, and we're not in favor of the establishment. We're not in favor of the corrupt system as we have it now. And I know that a lot of parts of the establishment wants to protect itself. I understand that. But Dinesh, you have to go to the root of the problem. And the root of the problem is, and I can trace it exactly to you. In 1971, there was a person who wrote for the Chamber of Commerce. His name was Lewis Powell. He wrote a letter saying, hey, you know what? The Chamber of Commerce can go buy different things. We're not buying enough things. We can go buy education. Let's go and chair different professors at different universities so that we can strike back against liberals. And one of his brilliant ideas was, let's go buy the Supreme Court. Let's give money to politicians so that they will allow us to influence the Supreme Court. You know what Richard Nixon did? It's like, that's a brilliant memo, young kid. Lewis Powell, you're now on the Supreme Court. And then Lewis Powell was a deciding vote in two Supreme Court decisions in 1976 and 1978 that said, yes, corporations are human beings. Yes, they have speech rights. Yes, they can spend money to bribe our politicians, which is mental. There's not a, raise your hand. Raise your hand if you think a corporation is a human being. Okay, I got three hands here. They must be with you, Dinesh. Okay.
Well,
so that is how they bought the system, lock, stock, and barrel. And then you turn around to politicians who are in this systemic corruption, and you go, it's your fault. And then you go, the business guy's buying them. Don't look at them. Don't look at them. They're the problem. They're both the problem. And you're only looking at one side of it.
All right.
Okay. It's got, you know, right here, basically. Look, if, you know, Cenk the Jenk and the Young Jerks at the Young Turks can talk all they want that they hate crony capitalism, they hate the establishment, they hate the system, they hate Hillary Clinton, they hate all of that. But guess what? You're a part of that system. You're involved in that every single freaking day. These are the rules. These are the regulations. You talk about, okay, that the Supreme Court ruled that corporations are speech, corporations are power, corporations can give money, corporations and entities like human beings, they have speech rights. They do. A corporation, why should a company or corporation be punished because they decided to make it an entity? It may be a sign, it may be a building, it may be, you know, a name on there, but it is something. And you have to play by the rules that are given to you. And if that's what's done, then guess what? Play within the rules. But right now, that's legal. So in this one here, I'm sorry, Cenk, but you know what? Dinesh, I mean, yeah, like reversals and takedowns or whatever, you know, big time. This one here went absolutely to Dinesh in terms of this. Anyways, that was the end of part two of this debate. Look for other videos too. There's a bunch of them out there. This was you, and as I said before, you're watching the Dr. Nasir Shaikh Show. I've been your host. My name is Dr. Nasir. Subscribe to our channel. Hit that notification bell. Like, share, and follow us. Put your comments down below. We really would like to know what you think about it. Tell me. Tell us. Tell everybody. Who do you think won? Was I right? Was I spot on? Or do you think I was spot off? Anyways, folks, I'll leave you with my final thought, which is, when you're right, you're right. And when you're left, you're wrong. We'll see you again next time, folks. Take care and stay safe.